I'll be sharing with you how I made roasted pumpkin seeds. Ta-da, they're crunchy and they're sweet, but we're also going to cover a savory version as well. So let's dive right in. This weekend I hosted a pumpkin carving party. It was a blast, but we had two buckets to make it pretty smooth in the kitchen and clean up afterwards. One was for seeds and one was for guts. The seeds one got so filled up, I was inspired to take those up to my kitchen and make this recipe with you guys. So here we go. I took the seed bucket and I rinsed these seeds in a strainer like so under cool water to get off any other remnants of the pumpkin guts that were on there. Then I took these seeds and placed them in a bowl, covered them with about 2/3 over top of water, cold water, and salt. And this is going to likely help with the digestion of these seeds. You can skip this step if you want, but I feel like it will be beneficial in the long run if you were to soak them. So 24 hours I had mine soaking. And then I rinsed them off and set them on a sheet. This one is like a towel mat. And I put it on there for them to dry off. You could also just set them down and pat them with paper towels if you like. Then all we're going to do is take our seeds in a clean bowl. Since I'm going to make two different varieties, I'll just use half of our seeds. Then I have some liquefied coconut oil. You just want to melt it down if yours isn't liquid yet. And I drizzle that over my seeds. For the sweet version, I like to add in about a tablespoon or so of coconut crystals. And then we'll go ahead and add in some pumpkin pie spice. And as much as you like. You can keep adding the spices. Play around with this. You can make this into any combination by changing the oils or changing the spices. It smells like fall. You can really customize this in any which way. I'm just showing you two options that I like to do. And I love the sweet one because the sugar kind of caramelizes as it roasts and it just is divine. They get extra crunchy and golden. And then all I do is on a baking sheet, I'm gonna spread this out. You wanna make sure that you lay everything flat and all of these seeds have their own space. And just flatten that out. You can either use your hand or the back end of a spoon, but you really wanna make sure each seed gets its own spot on the tray. No fighting for space on this tray. And you can either do them all on the same tray or you can use two separate trays for your savory batch. Then I'm going to take my savory batch right here, throw some seeds in the bowl, like so. Really simple. Love it! Homemade! You cannot beat this. Drizzle it again with some coconut oil, just to give it a nice little coating so that way our ingredients will stick. I'm going to use some sea salt. This is pink Himalayan sea salt. Use whatever you have and whatever you like, and as salty or not as you like. This is some black pepper. This one I'm doing a basic mix in here. I'm just using a smoked paprika. And that's it, three ingredients. I'm gonna twirl it around. As you can see, you can use a regular bowl and a regular metal spoon here. No fancy equipment. You're gonna preheat your oven to 350 degrees. And then you're gonna pop these bad boys in the oven for about 15 minutes. And you wanna flip them over about halfway through. Keep an eye on them because depending on your oven, it may cook faster. Keep an eye on that. So I'm gonna put my savory ones on the other half of our tray right here. Spread those out as well. Do your best to give everyone their space. Ta-da! Okay, we're gonna pop those in the oven and see what turns out. Okay, you guys, so our seeds are finished and this is the end result. We have a crunchy coated, caramelized, sweet, and delicious pumpkin seed that you can sprinkle on anything or eat as a snack. It's also a great gift to give out for Halloween. If you don't want to give out candy, give out homemade roasted pumpkin seeds. I mean, hello, if you can sweeten them with a little bit of coconut palm sugar or your favorite sweetener, isn't that a treat? All right, guys, if you enjoyed this video, if you like the recipe, then give it a big thumbs up and please pass it around and share it for a little holiday Halloween inspiration. Wishing you guys a fun, safe, and unforgettable unforgettable holiday season, and I thank you so much for watching. You can